Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I will do the review on Reprints calendar, advent calendar, that I bought this year. And I will not talk so much about how I think a calendar should be and you know, all that kind of stuff, because I did that in my first review for Yes Inc. And if you want to know what my expectations of an advent calendar are, then just go back to the review with Yes Inc. And the first couple of minutes I will talk all about that in that one. So we don't have to do that in every video, I think. So let's start with this review with Reprints calendar. And I just want to say, as I said in the last video, that this is just my personal preferences, my personal thoughts about the calendar and what I think and like and not like and so on. And you absolutely doesn't need to think the same as I do. I might like this calendar, you might not, or vice versa. So let's get right into it. So I first want to tell you what I bought this calendar for. This calendar cost 499 Swedish crowns. If you just buy this calendar, you have to pay shipping for 59 Swedish crowns if you don't buy anything else. I think that was a really, really good price. So let's see what I got in this calendar. So I will first show you the first 8 days of the calendar. Day 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And I really liked most of these products that I got the first 8 days. I love that there was a paper pack with their own papers from Reprint. I love that they actually had color coordinated most of this in the first days. Of course, there are some stuff that I don't like that much. You might do, I might not. And I love flowers. The first day we got all these flowers. So I think that was a really, really nice opening in this calendar because I love flowers. I love that the theme was green, actually. One day I had these adhesive stripes and green glitter. I really, really, really liked the first 8 days. The one thing that I didn't like so much was this one, stickers. It really felt a little bit like this is something you might not be able to sell. I don't know, because I don't use things like this anymore. When I started scrapbooking, there was a lot like this in the stores. It's not ugly, it's quite cute, but this is something I never ever use. So I will keep some of the stuff, I will not. I like that there was a green ribbon, fit perfectly with the paper we got and with the flowers that we got and the rhinestones. I really, really think, and the glitter is green too. So I really, really think that they really have put their, you know, they have really think it over. When they did this calendar, the first 8 days, they have really thought about that you should be able to be using the products together and so on. I actually really, really liked it. So this was the first 8 days. And the first 8 days I really think was like in green theme. The last one here for these days are this one in blue and silver. So I will show you the next 8 days in this calendar. So I will take this away. So here we will have the next 8 days. Day 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. So this is from day 9 to day 16. And here I think they have started to move over from green to blue. And we had stickles, frosted lace. I love stickles, and this will fit with, like, you know, everything, because the color is, you know, like white. We had one day 15 card bases in different colors, so it actually will fit the papers that we got. So we had 15 card bases. We had some charms. This is also reprints paper. So in this one we had two papers. They had to cut it apart to so it could fit the parcel, but it looks like this. So we got two paper with motifs, and that is perfect for those who doesn't like to color stamps or anything like that. So we had a paper who is like in green color, fit perfectly with the paper we got and stuff we got for the first 8 days. And the second paper was like in blue colors. So that fits perfectly with the colors we have now for the next 8 days, I think. I really like these papers. I love the old look of the motifs. We had flowers, we had a silver ribbon, we had a stamp alphabet, and we had blue pearls. I love pearls, I love stickles, I love flowers, I love charms, you know, I love silver. I really think this was a nice next 8 days in the calendar. On day 13, on Lucia, we got all these white flowers. I actually really did like that it was a full pack of white flowers on Lucia on that day. I don't know if they had a thought behind it, but Lucia have a white dress on when she comes, and we got white flowers, a whole pack of white flowers. So I think on the day Lucia, this was a great gift, actually. So this was then the gift we had from day 9 to day 16. So let's move over to the last 8 days in the calendar and see what we got. We have day 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, and 24. So this is the last days of the calendar from day 17 to day 24. So what do I think about these ones? I actually think that the first 8 days was a little bit better than the last 8 days in the calendar, and maybe it should be vice versa, that you have, you know, in the calendar that the products is better and better and better and better, but this is really nice products. We have some doilies. I really love doilies on my projects. Maybe the only thing I think is that you could have a full pack of doilies instead of open them up and split them. But I actually like that we have two sizes of them. It's really, really nice. I like doilies, so that is okay. We also had a paper pack again. So this is the second paper pack that we got in this calendar. And the collection is coffee. So this is nice. We had a brown ribbon. I think that this is one of the things that I didn't like. I would have been happier if this had been white, red, or green. But for those who like to make vintage projects, I think this is a really nice ribbon. I would have preferred maybe a thinner ribbon, But as I said, you won't like everything in a calendar, but that is totally okay because I like the mostly of the products in this calendar. We had some brads. It's hearts in brown and yellow. We had this wooden stamp with silver ink with it. We had gray flowers. We had red brads. Red brads is really nice to have if you want to make your own Christmas flowers. And on day 24 we had this paper pack. I love that it was a paper pack in day 24. And I think that this is, you know, moving forward for Valentine's Day, wedding cards and so on. That maybe starts after New Year. So I really, really like the gift in number 24, Christmas Day as it is here in Sweden. Because I always think that day 24 in a calendar should be something extra. I really, really think that because that is the day we are waiting for. So this was actually the last gifts from day 17 to day 24. I like most of it, maybe not this ribbon, and I don't think I will keep the stamps because I have so many happy birthday stamps. But overall, I think this was a really, really great calendar. I really think that for this price, the calendar was totally okay. I will buy this calendar next year too, if they will have one. That is how I feel. I really have many, many favorites in this calendar. I'm really, really curious if you feel like you would like to buy this calendar next year, if they have a calendar then too. So I hope you like this video, and next video will be the last one for my review on Magnolia. And I hope I will see you then. Bye-bye!